Hi guys, it's Mike here, One Go ShortPlay, playing Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, like most people who own the Master System, I think, I spent many, many years playing this. Well, no, playing the original Alex Kidd. Alex Kidd in Miracle World. Because it came free on... Oh, Master Systems, right, that killed you. Came free on Master Systems. And it was an awesome game. I remember playing this on the Mega Drive years ago. I'm going to be a little bit rusty, I'm afraid, so bear with me. Yeah. He crawls. Oh, man. Getting the time right for those punches is nasty. Oh, wow. Down to zero lives already. We may see a replay. We may see another go at this. Because I don't feel I'm doing it justice at all. Right. I'm not even bothering with coins and whatnot. I just want to see how far I can get. We could start battling it out for those treasure chests, but... Oh, right, gotcha. Yeah, Alex Kidd and Miracle World on the Master System was an awesome game. It was... I mean, it felt like a current game of its time. First thing I'm going to say about Alex Kidd and the Enchanted Castle for the Mega Drive is, bear in mind, it's a next-gen console. While the game boasts more colours, and, you know, the usual Mega Drive upgrades, I think what it's missing is that Mega Drive feeling. Before Sonic, Alex Kidd, I think, was kind of Sega's mascot. Which, I don't know. I think he was always going to be a bit of a fail. He's just a bit alien to... You know, the stylizing of him is a bit alien to the West. And, it was an ill-thought-out idea, I think. But he was... So his game, really... Oh, that was close. Probably should have been quite... A bit more of an advance from the Master System version than this is. I don't know what I'm trying to say. I do know what I'm trying to say. I lose my eloquence when the microphone comes out, you know. I'm normally a bit more well-spoken than this. Oh, don't sit there. Really? Need? Oh, see, that's rubbish. Right, we're going over the top. It's kind of... I don't think he translates to the Mega Drive very well. Oh, alright, one more go. Because that was god-awful. I don't think he translates to the Mega Drive very well. Don't get me wrong, the original game was very frustrating. For all the right reasons. This one's got that too. It doesn't feel like much of an advance from the original. It does feel like the original. And it's a bit faster and pacier and quirkier. Ooh. Oh, man. It's nasty. It's just... I don't know, it's Mega Drive, isn't it? It feels a bit Master System. There's something about the way the animations work, the way the gameplay is designed, that feels a little bit Master System. Yeah, they've got parallax scrolling. Yeah, they've got loads going on. And they've added moves, and this little jump kick's kind of cool. I'm figuring it out. If you hold the button down, he jumps. If you let go of the button mid-jump, he kicks. Kind of nice, simple mechanic. It works pretty well. It's a little confusing at first. But, you know, it's there. It doesn't feel like a big enough advance from the original. Something about it I never liked as a kid. I never got into. I think also, poor Alex Kidd here might have been at a bit of a disadvantage. Because, let's face it, most people, myself included, started really getting into the Mega Drive when Sonic came out. And that's frustrating. And Alex Kidd never stood up to it at all. It's not a bad game, it's pretty cool. It's just, it's not. It didn't have the impact that Miracle World had for me. Anyway, Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.